I'm really curious what her mega railgun is gonna be. I'm hoping for some sort of ultra automatic weapon or something, but you know, whatever. All right, so let's get it going. Let's get it going in 3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go. Okay. Let's see what we're dealing with here. It is kind of a automatic one. Dang, that's pretty sick. That is pretty sick, actually. Just have to try to make use of it in an actually effective manner. That's interesting. I would guess it's weaker than the normal railgun, because having an automatic railgun that's super powerful, like normal style power, would be kind of ridiculous. Like, kind of ridiculous. I wonder how this is gonna work for, like, mine cans and wasp cans and all that, though. Because, my goodness, we already have real shitty, wasp handling without. Yeah, that is pretty weak, honestly, and we took a dumb down there, so. Go me. Go me! Hey, Valiant Cheese, how you doing? Good to see ya. Good to see ya. We're doing the best we can with our good old mega weapons. This is really the first time I've ever used mega weapons in Shiitake, so it's gonna be a bit of a learning experience, as it already is, but that's okay. I mean, that's why we're here. That's why we're here. Well, no, that's not true. We're here to go fast. We're here to go fast. And if that involves learning, I guess we'll just have to deal with it. It's bugging a really early build where you could enable and control the 4 characters on mouse and keyboard. I think I've managed to, maybe not. I think I remember running into that, maybe not recently, but some time ago. But I don't know that it was any fault of the game. I think my control setup was all fudgy that time. But that sounds absolutely hilarious. That sounds hilarious, and I can't imagine doing it with, like, 4 shiitakes or something. That would be just absolutely serious. Absolutely silly. Just too silly. Like, I'm all for silly shit every now and again, but that is just too silly. Like, how would you manage such power? Actually pretty nice. I am probably gonna miss the propeller mines once we get to zone 2, though. But we'll just have to make do, you know? Sometimes you can't have it all. And sometimes you can have it all, but you don't do good things with it. Oh shit, there's still a dude left. I thought that was all. It's absolutely silly having an automatic railgun. I kind of love it. Battery here. Yeah. Short controlled bursts, I think, is the way to go. Short controlled bursts, or treat it like an automatic sniper rifle or something. Easy peasy. Alright, still kind of slow, but that's alright. That's alright. I mean, Shiitake, you expect a little bit of slowness here. Yeah, that's definitely not as bulky powerful as the mines for doing single target. But, you know. It's something. It's something different. It's something different. Still as easy as ever. Alright, so we're looking at like a 645 zone 1. Not bad. Not terrible. Not great, necessarily. Alright, see, now having wasps and shit is gonna be a little bit super dumb, considering the very narrow area we're gonna be able to impact with this thing. Zone 2 will probably not be our best zone, considering how many Wasparinos we're dealing with. Just need to make sure we get a firepower going here. Small shift in balances and mechanical behavior is enough to make a game feel fresh and new. Yeah, that's... you're very right. You're very right. I kind of regret not doing mega campaign runs earlier, but... you know, when you run a game for going on 4 years now, you gotta find some way to have your fun with it. Three hive. Well, about what I would expect considering all the wasps.
Here.
boy. I'm not looking forward to Vespi with this, though. My goodness, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. $30, that's a little bit better. $21, even better. And grab that firepower before it turned, but big old failure. Too bad.
Thank you.
47, sure. Sure, sure. Okay, zone 2 isn't too terrible. First level obviously wasn't the greatest. When they would pulse out again and give me a bit of a space to maneuver around. No such luck, though.
Protect me.
That wasn't as bad of a Vespi as I was expecting. Took that dumb down on Wasp 2 there. But if I hadn't taken any downs, I would have been surprised. Okay, seemed like a reasonable checkpoint. Good old casual ass plus there. Alright. Probably didn't even need to do the spin there. A lot of dancing there. Pretty good. Pretty good management there.
Thank you.
230. Ooh, that's a little spicy. Yep, okay. Kind of expected. Okay. couple dumb downs there. Buck 49 though, still pretty good. Exactly. Was bad as always.
Initiating containment protocol. Establishing defense perimeter.
Pretty much of a pushover justice.
Thank you.
54, okay.
Firepower extended.
a pretty nice assembly. Thank you. 227. Nice. Dookie. Nice. I just waltz into that entire spread. That's the way to do it. Vespi wasn't too bad. Wasn't too bad. We took a couple silly downs on a couple of the wasp phases, but honestly, that was expected. 100% expected. But the non-ball phases were pretty good, actually. Surprisingly good, in fact. Wasps as a whole are still kind of a pain in Shiitake's rear end here, but not really a whole bunch you can do about that. Yeah, that's not gonna end well. It traipsed through that group of bugs way too much. Fuck. Like, ah, crap. Doggo's gonna grab me. That'll be the end of that. Oh, look at that, I was right. Focus, sure. Remembered the mines that time. Split main pays off. Oh, jeez. Almost forgot him that time, though. Thirteen repeater, wow. Okie dokie. Oh good, the easiest boss. Actually this should be a little bit easier since we don't have to get super up in his grill with the mines. Just kinda go at any distance, honestly. That was fun. That's a touch easier than trying to get all up in there, you know? Nice! Oh, come on, really? Couldn't quite pull that one out. Womp. Fuck you, Venom. Dang. Almost clean. Almost real clean there. Accelerate. Oh, come on. Even heard the swap noise there. Pretty good, though. Pretty good. 201, almost a sub 2. It's pretty impressive. Well, it would have been. It would have been pretty impressive. No, this is a normal campaign, not campaign plus. Haven't quite gotten to that just yet. That's why we're blazing the trail so quickly through a lot of these. Normal campaign, the machine gun's on the bottom. In campaign plus, they shift it over to the right. It screws up muscle memory. Yep, you had him flipped then. get scared there. Get shut down. Nice. Wow. That's pretty good convection. Sub 3 in casual S plus. Sure. Sure, sure, sure. Sure, sure, sure. My goodness. There. Try to keep her away from that one. Oh! Dang it. That's right. It's just good old-fashioned railgun slug up the head. Licorice has her mega weapons equipped. No. That would be interesting. Be an interesting go of things. No. F you. Eh? Eh? You wanna dance around a little bit? Okay. Okay. Dude, be an idiot like that? That's fine. I ain't gonna stop ya. There we go. Very clean Licorice fight. Nice casual S plus Licorice too. 209. Very good. Well, I don't think we'll manage a sub 50 here, but it's gonna be close. It's gonna be a little close. If we end up doing better than our coral run, that's gonna be a little embarrassing, huh? Still pulled it out. Ooh, yeah, this is gonna be real close to a 50. A nice flat 50. But not quite. Whoops! Aw, oh, nuts. Pretty good. Be a 50-30 and a little bit of change, perhaps? Yeah, 50-30-98. Not bad. Not bad.
These readings make no sense. For the safety of everyone on board,
we should... Yes, yes, thank you, Aubergine. Always looking out for our safety. What a gal. What a gal. Alright. Cool.